Yo, what's good, guys? It's GM Jidel, and today we're going to be rebuilding the Toronto Raptors. This is the second to last team to rebuild before we have rebuilt all 30 teams. Obviously, the Raptors don't need a lot of help. They don't really need me to rebuild. They're pretty much a title contending team. In 2K, they always seem to make it to the finals in their first year, even though in real life, Milwaukee obviously are the one seed. I feel like Milwaukee doesn't get a lot of respect in this game, but the Raptors sure do. So I don't really even want to touch the team that much. The only thing I think this team really could use is like a 77, 78 overall kind of bigger wing. You know, someone like a 6'8 small forward who can kind of play make, shoot a little bit. Don't know if we're going to get that. In free agency, we could kind of get that with like a Manu. But, you know, he's retired, so we're not going to sign him. Z-Bug or Top, we don't really need them. Melo could maybe be that guy, but we all saw how Melo played this year. Not the way I want him on the Raptors. So I'm not going to touch the team unless we get some sort of crazy trade offer. This might be the shortest rebuild. There's a chance we just win in the first year. So let's simulate to the day before the trade deadline and see how things shake out, I guess. Let's just jump into it. Like we're Philly D or something. All right, we're being offered Mike Conley for Lowry. They're both 85 overall point guards, but I am kind of curious to see what the differences between them are. A, playmaking, B minus 3-point scoring, B plus perimeter defense, okay. B 3 plus, A playmaking, B plus perimeter defense. They're the same height, same rating. Lowry's 20 pounds heavier. Oh, this is tough. I think Conley is a little smidge better than Lowry, I'll be honest. It's close, but I think Conley's better. I'm gonna do that trade. Hopefully, you know, that doesn't screw us. Hopefully we still are on our way to winning the title. It's still a stacked team. We'll see. We'll see if that makes us worse or better. I don't know. Obviously, it's going to take a chemistry hit at first, but okay, so we were definitely a bit worse after that trade. Hopefully that trade isn't the end of us. We finished the year 54-28. A little disappointing. I thought we could scratch 60 wins. We're the 2 seed though, going against the Pistons. I'm expecting us to win this series against the Pistons. There we go, up game 1-0. I'm actually expecting us, if we lose the East, I'd actually be kind of disappointed just because, you know, the computer always seems to, why are we losing to the Pistons? Okay, 2-2 with the Pistons. Come on now. We shouldn't lose to the Pistons. All right, and the Warriors narrowly beat the Jazz. So look, if the Warriors don't go to the finals, we could just win and this will be like the shortest rebuild we'll ever do. All right, we're 2 wins better than the Celtics. I think we're gonna beat them. I'm basing this a lot off, you know, the previous rebuilds that we've done and how they've gone. But here the Celtics are up 3-1 against us. Okay, did they change their team at all? Nope, they didn't really change their team at all. So this is depressing. If we just lose in the first year, that's gonna be really sad. The Raptors always go to the finals when the computer is playing as them, but when I'm playing as them, nope. All right, so game 5 is at home, so we should win this one. Okay, did we start the game like 30-0 there? All right, well, hopefully, you know, we only won by 15, even though we started the game like 12 or 14-0. Come on, game 6, please tell us we're gonna win this one. Oh man, we only won the first quarter. We're getting destroyed here in this third quarter. I'll speed it up. We're down 14, so we're gonna lose to the Celtics. That is so frustrating. Every time I watch the computer, they just go to the finals. But when I do it, no. I lose to the Celtics, the team I always seem to beat. And so the Warriors are gonna win the title, it looks like. Yep, all right, so now we actually have to do a rebuild. I was actually thinking maybe, you know what, maybe I get lucky. Maybe I just win in the first year. Nope, losing the second round. I actually underperform. All right, the Spurs have our pick. That's a little disappointing. And our team is getting older, so if we don't really win it this next year, that could be kind of a problem. With our last 56th pick in the draft, we will take, oh man. Let's take McCurr. All right, so Leonard declined his player option and Gasol accepted his. I'm okay with that, even though hopefully Gasol does not decline too much in this offseason. So Leonard, obviously we need to re-sign him. He's the big dog. And Kawhi re-signed with us. Ooh, I don't really want to renounce the rights to Lin or Danny Green because we kind of need them. We need guys on our bench and we need Danny Green to start, honestly. So I'm gonna offer Danny Green a contract too and Jeremy Lin. So Lin, Green, and Kawhi are all coming back. I kind of want to just run it back with this team, to be honest. I don't really see what other options we really have other than to just run it back since we got Kawhi back. Let's try to bring in Wesley Matthews, just another guy to have on the bench, kind of a wing. We had backup guards. We didn't really have backup, you know, guys who play the three on the bench. So now that we have Wesley, is that move going to put us over the top? I don't know about that, but, you know, team didn't get a lot worse. Actually, it seems like it got a little bit better. Danny Green got a lot worse, so that, and Wesley Matthews got a lot worse. That's not good for us, because we really do need, well, honestly, for the shooting guard position, I feel like we just need someone who can hit threes and play a little bit of defense on this team. We don't need our shooting guard to do too much for us, I feel like. All right, so our rotation is Mike Conley, Norman Powell, Kawhi Leonard, Pascal Siakam, Marc Gasol. Really good starting lineup, in my opinion. Really well balanced, well constructed. And the bench, Ibaka, Van Vliet, Lin, and Anunoby. And none of these other guys get minutes, not even Danny Green or Wesley Matthews. Maybe we should try to find some sort of trade package for those guys by the trade deadline. So we're going to simulate to around the trade deadline again. All right, we're here February 4th. The team's doing really well. We're 36-14. Celtics are the number one seed, so that's obviously not good for us. But we actually have a much better point differential than them, so it seems like we're the better team. In the West, Warriors fell off a little. They didn't fall off. They didn't fall off at all, actually. They're right about as good as we are. So are the Nuggets. So I do feel confident against any West team other than the Warriors. So I'm just going to keep the status quo. I don't think we need to make a change. The team is starting to play really well. Better than we were with Lowry, so the trade just needed time. Just needed time for the guys to gel, you know? All right, so we finished with 54 wins again. We were really bad that last month of the season, so hopefully that doesn't carry over. We're the 3 seed this year, and again, we're on the same side of the bracket as the Celtics, so that is scary, since apparently the Celtics own us. Hopefully we're gonna beat the Miami Heat. Dragic's a 79. This team is not that good, but they do have Zion. They still have Justice. Looks like they traded away Josh Richardson. Oh no, he's on the bench now. Okay, it's a good team. I don't think it's as good as our Raptors team, obviously. There's a reason we're the higher seed, and it's 1-1. You know, I'm looking at the bottom too. Boston just beat Cleveland by 65 points. We're down 2-1 to a team we're definitely better than them.
Hours later.
Can you move it along? I'm all out of time cards.
We're down 3-1 of the Miami Heat. We're a lot better than this team. All right, we're winning, but it's close. There they are. There's the Miami Heat storming back, beating us in the first round. I'm so internally angry right now. You guys have no idea. We just lost to the 6th seed. We got clobbered. I have destroyed the Toronto Raptors with one trade. The Mike Conley trade might go down as the worst trade in the history of 2K trades. Was I that stupid? I just had to make a move, didn't I? I couldn't just accept that if I did nothing, I probably would have won. Could have been a short video. No. I had to mess it up. All right, 25th pick in the draft. Who are we taking? Jalen Smith. Qualifying offers. Nwaba. You know what? Why not? Siakam, of course. If we don't get Siakam back, we could be screwed. All right, Siakam is accepting. And, oh man, we need to re-sign Ibaka and Gasol and Van Vliet. I'm going to offer Gasol a little 2-year deal. God, we got to bring Ibaka back too. Oh, this is rough. All right, we brought them all back. Van Vliet is not as important to bring back, in my opinion. I'm signing Aaron Baines to a little 2-year deal to get some more depth at big man. Okay, we're going to need to get rid of Green and Wesley Matthews, though. So let's do that now. And we'll get a lottery-protected Spurs pick in JaVale McGee. I don't love that JaVale contract, but you know what? Screw it, we'll take it. Okay, so the rotation really hasn't changed much in year 3. Conley, Powell, Leonard, Siakam, Gasol. Probably the last year that this lineup will kind of work. I imagine Conley's going to go down, Gasol will go down. The bench, Ibaka, Baines, Lin, and Anunoby. Hopefully we can move up some of our other guys. I'll G League Jalen Smith this season just because it looks like he won't get playing time on our team. But I am going to try to swing a trade to get another backup bench guy. We have a little bit more draft capital now with that Spurs pick, but the team should be pretty good this year. I don't see why we would be a bad team. We should be better than 54 wins by my estimation, but we'll see. You know, I've been wrong about everything so far. All right, we were a 30-9 and now we're 36-19. We're 6-10 in our last, like, 16 games. Definitely feels like a trade is in order here. All right, I can swing Baines, JaVale, and Anunoby into Schroeder. Seems like a good deal to me. We're gonna obviously have to turn Jeremy Lin into something else, but getting Schroeder, that's a good pickup for us, I think. I'm gonna try to see if I can trade Lin in 2 picks. this seems like the move to me. I don't know anything about this Jordan McRae guy, I'll be honest. But hey, he comes with Ken Birch, and I have to give up a lot of picks. But this is it. I'm going for the title. You know, this is what it takes to win the title in my estimation. You got to go all in. So now the lineup is Conley, McRae, Leonard, Siakam, Gasol, the bench, Ibaka, Schroeder, Ken Birch, Powell. So the bench is better. Starting lineup's a little bit better. We gave up future assets to do this, but hey, we're going for the title. And we finished with 53 wins. We were a game worse. We're the 2 seed again, but we are going against the Miami Heat, who Zion didn't improve that much for them. Somehow we got stuck on the Boston bracket again, but you know, should I really fear the Celtics that much? I don't know if I should. They're a pretty good team, I'll be honest. I don't know if we're better than them, but hopefully luck is on our side. It has not been in the past, this rebuild. The Miami Heat, the 7 seed, take game one. We take game two. For the love of the Lord, let us win game four since we just lost game three. I hate this game. I hate this game so much. Sometimes I sit back and wonder, you know, if I never traded Lowry that first year, would I have just won the championship and that's it? I just would have won the title. We would have been done. We're down 3-1 to the Miami Heat, a 7 seed. We're the 2 seed. All right, let's do this. Let's try to come back. All right. I'm closing my eyes. I am closing my eyes. All right, I'm gonna open my eyes. We lost. We freaking lost. That's so frustrating. I feel like, I don't even know, did the Conley trade ruin everything? Or did my bad luck ruin everything? That's the question. We don't have our pick because we traded it because we went all into the finals that year. The only guys we really need to re-sign are Conley and Birch. Conley, man, I thought you might have been the one to really help bring this team around. I am not giving you a 5-year deal. Hell no. I'll give you a player option. Boom. Ladies and gentlemen, the crazy trade of the video has come. Now, most of you are gonna think this trade might be a little goofy. You're not wrong, but Gasol, as we all know, his offensive rebounding was below 50. His three-point shooting is now at a C-, and his playmaking's at a C. DeAndre Jordan is younger. He's actually a higher overall. He's on a contract that I don't love because it's 3 years long. But the dude, you know what? For all his faults, people on the Mavericks, they say he doesn't play hard anymore. They might be right. Does 2K know that? I don't think 2K knows that. He's still got a pretty high rating here in the future. It's an 83. I think he's gonna help me win more games than Gasol will, so we're gonna trade him. Serge Ibaka, Jalen Smith. We could get Malcolm Brogdon for these guys. And if we do that, means we can trade Norman Powell too. Let's just make sure we can actually get something for Norman Powell. All right, we're gonna trade Norman Powell for Rashawn Holmes and a pick back. And then we're gonna trade Ibaka and Jalen Smith, who, you know, a young guy, you know, I don't wanna give up on a young guy, but we're gonna get Malcolm Brogdon. I can't trade Mike Conley till December 15th. But for now, the rotation, Mike Conley, Malcolm Brogdon, Leonard, Siakam, DeAndre Jordan. This might be the best starting lineup ratings-wise, we've had the whole video. The bench is still pretty good. Schroeder, McRae, Birch, Holmes, Mater McCurr. I like it. We're gonna explore a Conley trade when we get there. That's December 15th, so we'll go to December 30th. I can see this team being pretty good. All right, we beat the Heat by a point to end the season, but I did notice we lose all of our other matchups against them. And we're the number one seed. Of course, we're on the same side of the bracket as the Miami Heat and the Boston Celtics, but thankfully they will take each other out. This should be our year. This should be our year. We're going against a 37-win team in the first round. If we lose a game, that would be embarrassing. Okay, we're up 2-0. We lost a game. We lost a game to a 37-win team. And of course, the Heat won, who have dominated us. We're going to a game 7 against a 37-win team! What the f*** is going on? This team's not even that bad. How did they only win 37 games? Jeez. All right, game 7 at home. Okay, come on. Guys, they're a 37-win team. They lost 45 games during the regular season. Do I jump in? Oh my God! Best record in the NBA. We lose to a 37-win team. I wanna see something. We're back in year one, everybody. We're back in year one. I'm not touching the team. Back in year one, I'm not touching the team. Wow. So, if I never touch the team, we lose in the finals to the Warriors in five. Mind you, with all the moves I've made, the furthest we got was the first year we got to this point, where we lost to the Celtics. Was the Mike Conley trade, like, the worst trade in the history of the NBA, or am I just unlucky, or... I don't know what's going on here, but all right, let's go back. We have one more year. We have one more season to try to fix this Raptors team. Otherwise, they're just cursed or I just suck. It's one of the two. I'm cool with either, to be honest. My camera might die, everybody, so just keep that in mind. All right, Conley accepted his player option. Qualifying offer to Ken Birch. Really hope he stays. You know what, Mike Conley? I think you really might have been the reason we lost this whole thing. I'm just gonna trade you straight up for Vooch. We need a point guard. We need a point guard, I know. All right, I brought back Jeremy Lin. I'm just gonna match offers for Birch and Mature. All right, Birch and Mature are back for the last year. Here we go, here comes the wild ride. Leonard declined, oh no. All right, Schroeder, Brogdon, Leonard, Siakam, Vucevic, the bench, DeAndre Jordan, Ken Birch, Jordan McRae, Kai Anderson, Antoine Moore. Ah, this is the team. Actually, why isn't Jeremy Lin getting any minutes? All right, goodbye, Antoine Moore. Hello, Jeremy Lin, you are gonna get those minutes. This is the title team. We're either gonna lose the title or we're gonna win the title. Did I just say whiz the title? I meant to say lose. Camera's about to die. We're going balls to the walls here. Hey, we beat the 47-37 win Wizards team, finally. Took us all off season to figure that one out. You guys are wondering why I'm getting so angry at it. You know, every passing second of this video, I just find a way to look more and more incompetent as a GM. I'm getting exposed out here, okay? I'm getting exposed. Thank you.